against England, and it's Madison Hughes and Gareth Rees.
Thank you, Ricky. The Canada Sevens champions are dethroned. South Africa will not lift the cup this year. Who will join them in the cup quarterfinal? It's Argentina raring to get on the field, and England. It's been some time since South Africa haven't lifted that cup. Both of these teams will be fighting for it. England in their untraditional purple jerseys, and number four, Mr. Dan Norton, perhaps fitting that the England team fought to get him into this top eight. Cup appearance for Dan Norton there, and Argentina had some success here. They'll always rely on Gaston Ribol, their captain. But keep an eye on Luciano Gonzalez. So impressive the last few weeks. Happy to be joined by former US Eagle captain Madison Hughes. And Madison, this is what we look forward to, a great cup quarterfinal like this.
No, the cup quarterfinals, they're often even the most exciting matches. You get the big upsets, both teams raring to go at the start of day two, and I'm really excited for this. Argentina looked controlled yesterday, England fought their way in. This should be a good one.
And another American in the middle, Cisco Lopez, our referee. Roddick will get us underway. Kick to the left. 50-50 ball. It was knocked back by Argentina, so play on, and now it's going to be a penalty against England holding on. Ribol will build the attack, and the Argentinians not afraid to go through some phases to complete some passes before they get their work done. There is obviously another man to watch, Moneta, World Rugby Player of the Year. There's an absolute love for the game. There's a wonderful feature on him. The work he did in Vancouver this week, helping kids, and also just his love of the Sevens game up on the World Rugby website. There he is. On the end here, looking for a pass, and he hits it. It's actually Gonzalez who intercepts. Luciano Gonzalez hits it hard and gets Argentina on the board.
Argentina controlled attack there, going width to width, stretching the England defense. Nothing particularly complicated, but winning the collisions, winning that game line battle, and Gonzalez going over in the corner. England playing seven up defensively, so that should give them the width and the numbers to defend. It'll be interesting. Argentina love a kick in behind, so that might be something we see in for them later, especially to Moneta.
A clinical start here. Just over a minute played. Beautifully struck conversion. You'll be proud of that one, Madison.
Absolutely. I mean, anytime you can start off the game, I feel like seven is a massive difference than five. So getting that conversion crucial for Argentina, and now they look to stretch it straight off this kickoff.
As I mentioned, England lost their first two games yesterday against Fiji and USA, and then bounced back with a close win against Kenya. And that was enough with points difference to get them here to this cup quarterfinal. So can they provide a moment for Dan Norton, who's announced some big news this week in the sevens world? Ribol hits it hard. There's an open man on the end. Gonzalez, Santiago Gomez Cora, his coach, calls him the bulldog. And that could be a problem for England. It could be Dan Norton going to the bin.
No, time is up.
He wants to have a look on the big screen. He's knocked it down out of the scrum half's hand. Must be deemed a cynical play.
Yeah, I think his only recourse would be if he was saying he struck it backwards. But I think that's something the referees are always going to call intentional knock on there. His hand is going backwards in the motion, but I think anytime you do that to the nine, you're going to get that yellow card. And not the way Dan Norton would have wanted to go in what could be his last cup appearance for England. But tough task now for England. They've got to defend with six from this 5 meter scrum. So Argentina, they'll want to score immediately, get back on the attack, and have another opportunity in this yellow card period.
Fine.
So because of the obligation at scrum time, there's only two defenders to cover three Argentinian attackers. Open field. Let's see if Ribol uses it. You see, they're short. They've got a lot of ground to cover. Moneta's going to go for the corner. Too much ground. Marcos Moneta for Argentina.
Yeah, you're not going to stop Marcos Moneta when he's got that much space out wide. All comes from the yellow card and the scrum. England got very tight defensively, I think, saying to Argentina, if you are going to score, it will be in the corner. We're going to make this kick very difficult for you. Of course, earlier he did make the touchline conversion, so we'll see if he can do it again this time.
Was the top try scorer at the Olympics in Tokyo, where his team picked up a bronze. great moment for Argentinian rugby, given how much they've contributed to the series over the years. Marcos Mineta, a natural, he loves the game. As we mentioned, was awarded that World Rugby Sevens Player of the Year during COVID times in front of his teammates, but not in a big fancy gala, but a nice moment for him nonetheless. England, chance to respond here. They're down two scores. They're one short for the moment. Dan Norton still has 20-odd seconds to serve in the sin bin. Smart play from England just to grind it up. We were talking before the break, Master, too. Also, six against seven. Sometimes a chance to use the kicking game.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if England have the ball here, so... But if Argentina had the ball, England would have had to pull up a number defensively. And so frequently there is more space in behind. Obviously the risk reward of that is an important factor to decide on.
Tackle.
Well, Norton Sinbin is served, but he won't re-enter the field until there's a stoppage.
Hold on there, Fee, hold on.
England hoping that's a try.
Ball's there.
Ball's available, says our referee. Well, numerous phases for England. This is impressive. Back against the grain is Blake Boylan. Now he's free. Running hard. What an outstanding 2 minutes of play for England. They kept the ball. They drained the clock, and now they've come up with a try for Blake Boylan.
Boylan, fantastic individual work. Arcs his way through the line. He spotted the Argentina defense. They knew they had an extra number, so they came up really high to prevent the pass. But sometimes when you get that vertical defense, it does open up a gap. Boylan arcs his way through and has the pace to go the distance. And England have actually won that yellow card period 7-5 over Argentina. So they've done fantastically well. Dan Norton coming back on the field should be fresh and raring to go with just under 2 minutes left in this half. And now it's the time for Norton to provide his team the lift. The team have done the work for him while he's been off. Now can he provide the impact that he has done so many times over the years?
Well, we know Boylan has the pace, the former Welsh indoor athletics champ and under 16 level. That man has some pace too. Argentina ball.
Out now.
Counter ruck. 12-7. Argentina up by that second score. Again, they found space on the outside. Moneta's off and running. Far too easy. Marcos Moneta with his brace. And two of the great finishers in the game end up in the dead ball area.
England has got too tight defensively, and you cannot give Marcos Mineta that much space. You've got to be aware of where the players are and where the important players are. Looked like Jamie Anderson just kind of took a look in, looked at where the ball carrier was, and in that moment, Mineta slid slightly out, and by the time the ball was in his hands, he couldn't react. So you've got to be aware of Mineta on the outside there, even if it means that you've got to be making sure that your inside defender is working slightly harder, because you give him half a chance and he is going to take it.
And you know, Madison, when players like that are on the field, you have to be aware of where they are. You just cannot take your eye off them for a minute.
Absolutely. I mean, playing against Dan Norton for so many years, he's one of the players who you always have to know exactly where he is, because he is a unique threat, and Marcos Mineta is exactly the same.
Mineta creeping up that tournament try scoring list. Argentina go long, as is their wont. Good work from the big man stepping out. That's Afim Vadra. Ooh, tackle, man of all, that seems to be fair. Norton really gets his first touch in attack. The hooter sounded, but England looking for something. That's Jamie Barden, the supporting player. Boylan penalized. Argentina off. Up by 12, looking to add. England's penalties are costing them. Mineta keeps it alive this time. That's nice offloading from the Argentinian team. And the Bulldog goes over the line. Luciano Gonzalez with his second try.
Argentina being more effective against seven English defenders than they were against six, but doing very well. Just patient attack, working through the phases, English defenders slipping off the tackles, and penalties were costing England. That got them on the back foot, got them retreating, and anytime you're having to go backwards continuously because of those penalties, it is harder to defend.
Gonzalez with four tries in Singapore last week in his 35th event here, 45th, fourth event here, two more in this cup quarterfinal, and that'll do it for the half. Argentina dominating 26 points to 7. Announced that he will be completing after this event his time on the HSBC World Series. Argentina get their hands on it yet again. England in their purple jerseys have been on the receiving end for most of this first half. The physical presence of Argentina has been good, although they got their hands on it now for a moment. And that's Bedefeld.
High tackle.
Norton penalized for contact above the shoulder line, and Revol is going to take his time here.
I've been impressed by Argentina both yesterday and so far today. It's been very controlled. They haven't seemed to like they've delved too bad into their bag of tricks, but just composed, slowing things down when they need to, staying calm in attack, going through phases. I've been very impressed by Argentina, and they're going to look to build on this.
Well, you see that stat. They've won four of their five cup quarterfinals this year. They've got three bronze medals and one silver to show for it. They're looking to add gold here in Vancouver as Browning comes on the field for England. A little bit of a spark.
Comes off. Yeah, subs are coming. I didn't know.
And off goes Bavadra. As we said, Canada has not been a great hunting ground for England. They did win in 2017. You played against that group, I believe, and they had a big celebration here.
They did. They were did very well there. Only a couple members of that team still here, including Dan Norton.
Alex Davis, one of the others. Argentina coming up the middle.
You have to roll first.
Another penalty against England. They're starting to mount up. Right through the middle. Hard yards. The power and the pace of Lautaro Fernández. That's another one for Argentina.
Yeah, five penalties for England, zero for Argentina. So that's made it very difficult for them defensively. They've just been constantly retreating and forced to react to those penalties that are coming against them. So they're perhaps chancing things slightly too much at the breakdown. Need to have a look at that, what they're getting wrong, why they're being inaccurate there, because it's making it very hard for them defensively.
While the 26-year-old backed himself, conversions in front. Fernández, another of the Tokyo bronze-winning Argentinians, took his chance well there. Hanging kick, taken by Browning. England deep in their own end. Good width on the ball. And our highest try scorer in the series history really has not had any space. There we go. Browning.
Roll.
Argentina's not rolling away. Quick tap from Jamie Barden.
Advantage.
Advantage being played. Freddie Roddick on the ball.
Coming back.
They're going to come back with the original penalty.
Six, not ten.
Might have been Norton's chance in this game to stretch his legs, but England do retain possession, and they can see if they can build some attacks. And setting up the scrum, so this is interesting. So a lot of open space out to that right-hand side for England, so it'll be interesting to see if whether they can isolate Dan Norton out there.
How
nice would this be for the fairy tale? Just give Norton half the pitch, maybe put Mineta up against him and see who wins that battle, the great man, as we said.
Yeah, you know, I mean,
started in 2008 on the series. Incredible contribution to the game. I'm talking to Rob Vickerman, our colleague with the World Rugby Commentary, said he's really been a beacon for the England team, and he's an iconic sevens player from professionalism right through to the Olympics.
Set.
Dan Norton's done it all. England got a chance. They go right. Hard stepping is Will Homer. Norton enveloped, finally goes down to ruck. Oh, quick hands required, but good work to get out of the tackle. Speaking of high stepping, now Browning's in space. He's backed himself. He's gone for the corner. Joe Browning off the bench and in the try-in. Try zone.
Browning showing he's got the pace to finish it off, and the England team showing what they can do when they have the ball and are able to go through some phases. Probably not going to be enough. 2 minutes left on the clock. They could do it. It's going to take something special. But England finally getting some ball, getting into some space, and setting Browning off down the wing.
A little bit more urgency to the England attack. They got quicker ball. Conversion's a wobbler. It's not going to be good. Nice moment. 6'2" and 99 kilograms. One of the products from the Leicester Tigers Academy. Seem to be producing fullbacks of that size. Show and go for Argentina. Revolt demanding the ball. He knows where it wants to go. Out there. Out wide. And out for a try through Franco Savato for Argentina.
Very impressive, simple Argentinian attack. I loved how flat they hit onto the line there. They saw England were retreating defensively, and when that's happening, you want to hit on flat. Gaston Revol, he's done that so many times. He hit on so flat, which means that England defense couldn't shift out, and so Franco Sabato able to go in. And he's no slouch, but the inside attackers really gave him a lot of space to work with.
Sabato in his 57th tournament, member of that great club, alumni. Good to see him back. He missed Dubai, both events there. Well, Argentina very much in control of this third cup quarterfinal. Stay with us. Of course, we have Australia and New Zealand to follow in the final, semi-final place to be determined through that match.
Holding.
Another final chance for England here to end with a flourish. High stepping is Jamie Adamson. Good work from him. And there they go, quick pick from the base. Callum Randall backs himself. Couple meters short, he's not held, he scores.
Callum Randall with a fantastic little stutter step. There wasn't much space at all in there. But just a little shift of his body weight enabled him to pull away from Revol and just had enough momentum to slide over the line.
Well, this was the hard work done. Good bullocking run. And then when Randall arrived, he had the presence of mind to see there's no one at home in any kind of a guard position. Off the right foot, and look at this for finish. The 22-year-old had the pace to do it. And that should just about do it. England not quite as accurate as they need to be. Dan Norton will compete for the fifth place semi-final. We'll still get to see him on the circuit. Not the fairy tale finish. Gaston Revol can tap this off the field. But they've got to play on. Kind of the spirit. Give these fans a little bit extra to talk about. Again, stepping out. All sorts of tackles. England will have another chance at this. This is a never-ending game. 1 minute into extra time. Good hard line there.
Yeah, good, good.
Advantage being played. Again into space. But the jersey grab denies.
In touch, in touch.
Callum Randall can't get a second, and that will do it. In the end, it's Argentina 40, England 17. Argentina will go through the cup semifinal.